Hi everyone, and welcome to a new vlog. I'm gonna explain why I'm wearing this McDonald's what's it called, cowboy hat, and the cheesiest fries merch shirt, which I absolutely love, by the way. Absolutely love. In fact, I'll start with that, and then I'll go into the actual vlog. So this last weekend, myself and a friend of mine, we actually took part in the coolest campaign for McDonald's. I thoroughly enjoyed myself. We had such a good time. It was the Parklife festival. For those of you in Manchester or around or know anything about it, it is so great. It had amazing artists, collection of artists that were there. I was so excited because I got to see Wu-Tang Clan. They had like an amazing roster of different stages, the main Parklife one, BBC ones and other ones. It was a total vibe. But I was there, we were there for a McDonald's promotion, because McDonald's has started to get into festivals. So they wanted to really push that. So they're giving away free fries and free merch to anyone who sort of took a picture, popped it on their story and tagged them in it. And that's how you qualify for either one of these, which people were literally begging me for at the end, by the end of the festival. And one of these really cool shirts. But obviously I was part of the whole promo team, the whole press team. It was so fun. So what I was there to do was take content for McDonald's and for any of the festival goers, because we really wanted them to have a really, 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 really cool experience, and take pictures, feel comfortable, just give them angles. We were giving them angles upon angles so that they could, you know, they would love it and they'll post it. And then obviously they'll get one of these funky free shirts. And it was really cool because they set up like you know, the McDonald's, the M, they were like swings under the arches. So I'm going to insert all the footage of that. In fact, let's start with that and then I'll wind back, because I had such a nice kind of chilled couple of weeks doing work, doing some cool stuff, meet up with friends, leading up to this great festival. So let's kind of, I'll obviously put some footage in of that. Oh, and we got to work some really cool talent as well. So we were there just, who else came through? Like India, another girl from TikTok. And they were just the loveliest girls. They look exactly the same in real life as they do on screen. Beautiful girls and just full of fun. This is all fun. You can't take anything seriously. I absolutely love my shirt, by the way. I was like, I'm having one. I want one of those shirts. I'm not here taking content for everyone to get one of these, and I don't get one myself. So yeah, so we did that, met some great talent, and it was a successful campaign because I purposely asked them, have we all met our KPIs? Have we done it? Have we pushed it? Like, yeah, it was fantastic. It's done. Fry sold out. It was so funny. Like, if I was to break down the whole experience. Anyway, let's run with the footage and then I'll have to come back and tell you what happened, like other details, but you know, let's run with. That's what we're giving away to anybody who comes and gets their content taken by us, right at the swing. You can choose one of these or a hat or one of our funky shirts. So please tag us, McDonald's UK, or some free merch. Oh,
about to eat all of it. That's the right music. That is the right music for it. Oh.
Anna's party. Here I am in the dark. It was like 1:30 something in the morning. And because I didn't drink, I can drive home. I'm just really hungry, so I'm gonna eat when I get in. I'm wobbling. I'm totally wobbling. But it was a proper good night. It always is with them guys anyway. Good vibe. You can't see me. You can't see me. Hi everyone. Okay, so I'm having a really, really exciting weekend actually. It was my friend's 40th birthday. So we went to that yesterday, which was really, really cool, as you can tell from the clips. And today the party continues. We are going to the park. So I'm going to go into Coventry, which is about 15 odd minutes from where I live. I'm going to go there and just spend a day in the park eating some cake. Okay, so I've got some time to go before I go to this park. And I have to create some content, as usual. And then this time I thought I'll show, because I think in the last video I just showed the final thingy. So I'll talk you through what I do and how I do everything. And actually the camera I use is, my camera is like, I think it's an iPhone, I don't even know what it is. It's an iPhone 10 or 11 or something like that. I don't know, some iPhone 10X, I don't even know which one now. That's all I use. My brother did have like a proper, like a Canon camera and all this lenses and stuff, and he's got another one that you can use for film and things. So I used to use that, but I just found it so laborious to convert everything to the laptop, and then I just found it really boring, so I just used my phone because I found it was quicker. So that's what I use to take all those pictures actually, all the pictures, and I just send it straight to my computer and straight onto Canva and or whatever editing thing I'm using, mostly Canva these days actually, and just edit away. So my friend Tracy stayed over last Sunday and left me some flowers. So I wanted to build them into a story of what I'm going to be doing. Because what I want to do is to do like another a summer sort of fresh thing for Mary Smith. And just sort of show that through seasons, whatever, you can still use the body balm, and you can use it, especially if you're handling like gardening and flowers and things like that. So I'm going to show you the flowers and stuff like that. And actually, for those of you who don't know, the reason why I do a lot of photography with the body balm is because it is our best-selling product. Sorry, a bit of fluff. It is our best-selling product, this little thing right here. And it, because it's the customers who made it that way. If for those of you who don't know, we actually started off two parts, doing footwear and obviously doing this. This has always been around, but it was under another brand. But we came together and we decided to create the brand, and we got our footwear obviously made, which is great. I've got another video on the channel where I talk about how we got into luxury firms, because our footwear is made by the same people who make shoes for like Kate Webster. I forgot her name. Sophia Webster, and other stuff. And we have our clothing made by the same people who make for BCBG Max Mara. I'm probably saying all that wrong again. And actually, other luxury firms, that's what I'm just trying to say. Which is good. We still have all of those outlets, and we still want to go back and do it. But then we have to focus on what's the best selling to push that. And all the customers have made the body balm the best selling product. And it's great because it does work. And I use it every day. We've been using it for years. All our nieces and nephews have grown up with it. It's our formulation, so that's the pain again. It's our formulation, so obviously it was formulated in-house, but it's made in a factory in Liverpool. And it's so great. It's great for anti-aging on the skin. It's great for the whole body. And so anti-aging, sometimes you focus on the face, but this is good. The ingredients that are in here, it's 100% natural, and it's vegan friendly and cruelty free. But all the ingredients that are in here are designed to help the body with, what's it called, anti-aging, by just encouraging collagen production and in the body. And what else does it does? It has UV protection, low UV protection as well, like factor 10. So you can go ahead and still put your normal factors on there. It is, you can use it from your hair to your toes. I always use it in my hair, and like you can use it on your face. If it's too heavy, then you know, you don't have to do it. You can do it at night if you want. But for the body, it's great. Great for all the family. I don't think what else. Yeah, and it's good for all the elements, all weathers, because of the mango butter that's in there. So it's got things like mango butter in there, which is great for all the elements. Cocoa butter, shea butter, olive oil. It's got a very small percentage, natural blend of essential oils. And that serve a purpose, not just for the scent. They serve they're very good for antibacterial properties as well, things like that. So this is our body balm, which is just luscious. So I focus a lot of the marketing efforts that we do on that. And it is what it is. Sometimes in business, you have to look at what is working and focus on that. And this little product here has got us into John Lewis and Waitrose pop-ups and things like that. Okay, so I'm going to show you the flowers and I'm going to say what I'm going to do. Essentially, what I'm going to do is going to show the flowers, do like a whole flower story, like I'm arranging it, and then grab this to show that, look, I used this to help obviously protect my skin and things like that. Yeah? Okay, so let's flip around and show. So this is the flowers. So this is actually like a vase, but I haven't actually put the flowers straight in the vase. I've actually put them in, like this was like a Pepsi Max in there, put the flowers in there, because I don't want to, you know, when you have vases like this one, you have to keep cleaning. I'm not doing that. But this is, you can throw it away, stuff like that. So I popped that inside here like that, arranged it, cut it how I want, and I've placed it here by my plant, Rory. My adopted plant, Rory. And on this is a great, I think this was from Bristol. It's like Pured. And it matches the chair that I've got in here. This is like a little statement chair. Everyone freaks out when they sit on because it wobbles a bit. But yeah, so I've got it on this plinth thing now. And I'll insert what I do with it after. So I'm just going to arrange it like that, which is just lovely. It's beautiful. And then I'm going to have show the product that we use, which is the body balm. So I'm going to do something with it, figure something out, and then post away. It's beautiful, isn't it? It's beautiful. Thank you, Tracy. Thank you, Tracy. It might be more. Hey, Rita. Sasha watching the football. I didn't know Sasha was really into football like this.
Anymore. Get ready. Let's do it.
No, look at me, I'm on a ride. How do I agree to this? Right, I'll put this away, otherwise it's just going to be...
So after being coerced to go on a ride... I could barely drive home because I was so sick. It was disgusting. I had to like drink anything or take anything to kind of stabilize my insides. I had no plans of being on a ride. Thank you, Tamira and Camille. Anyways, it was still funny upon reflection. And now we just literally, we as in my sister and
her
family.
Show us your camera.
I'm just third wheeling with them as per usual. We're on our way to Figure Nor Live. Just to enjoy some time, to look around the place, look around it. It's like a garden center. It's really lovely in there, and they've got a really lovely deli, and I've eaten there before. It's been lovely. And then we're off to Lichfield. Yeah.
Orange. because the way that she just wants to be turned, like facing forward.
Sort of lovely bits for the garden. But we love all this kind of stuff. See, these are fake flowers. They're not real, but they look really, really good, don't they?
Yeah,
they are.
I just took a picture.
You did? Oh wow, show us.
I can't like it. Look at this.
Okay, let me watch you take it. Fantastic. Well done. Oh, it's right by your little pinky, because you're all matching because of the pink. Yeah. We just want to get it all for the house. We want to get it all. This is nice. I love this. Looks really cool. These display cabinets they've got. Come on. This way. I don't know if. Yeah, that's what you were doing your planting. Yeah. You put them inside here. Can you see? Put them inside there for planting. Look. Who's supposed to sit on these little stools?
They look so cute.
Oh, look at these
children.
Pardon? The hedgehogs. Yeah, we're going to go to the hedgehogs. Yeah, let's go. Let's go see the hedgehogs. You have some wholesome. Look at those goujons. Look at this Cornish pasty. That is a good Cornish pasty, if I ever to say. It looks tasty.
Tempting me,
Saturday, the weekend has begun, the bank holiday weekend, and we are back at the pool. I say back because I've been here like nearly every day since the sun's come out. This is at by David Lloyd's up here in Solihull, and literally the sun is shining. It's literally like we're abroad. So my sister's there. There she is. There she is. She's good actually, because she can do a whole length of this stuff, and she taught herself to swim, by the way, so that's good. And she's brought a couple of her friends here, and we literally are just chilling. We did do aqua aerobics in the morning, so that's why I'm extra chilling. I don't know what drove us to wake up to be here for 8:15 on a Saturday morning, but yeah. She's exhausted. Yeah. It's Amanda living vicariously through Ruth.
You see me flattering on the floor.
Yeah, I'll jump.
That's okay, she's getting some lemons. Yeah, I want. It's nice. I'm gonna get in it. I'm gonna take the thingy in. It's so nice. The heat gets slightly, and because the sun as well is shining, it's just so. It's nice. So Amanda, Ruth's friend, this one here, she is scared that she might drown in a pool that comes up to. She's quite tall, so pool's gonna come up to like her knees. So yeah, friends are trying to console her. Look, she said she's short. Ah, it's good times.
Sweet dreams are made of these. Who am I to disagree?
Had
such a good last few weeks, couple of days in between all this hard, intense work. This has been good. But that led off, obviously, that was last week. Well, the following week, that's the last weekend with the whole McDonald's campaign. So I think this is a nice time to kind of close this vlog, because I don't want it to be so long because there's just so much to do. But yeah, I thought actually I wish everybody who is working hard on projects for yourself. This whole working for yourself thing has its challenges, especially when you're in your own business. You're constantly trying to network, and you're constantly working on different things, and it can be a bit challenging. I want to encourage everybody that actually, honestly, it's going to be okay. Trust God, keep going. Just keep going, keep working hard, and use these little moments. Like, going to gym was inexpensive, like just chilling, just relaxing. Seize as many of those moments as you can and really live each day. When just let go when you can, and have just get through it, because I truly believe God, who brought you this far, will take you on. I truly believe that. And so yeah, have a good day, morning, evening, whatever, or afternoon, wherever you are. And if you can listen to I think it was episode 19. I'm not sure when I'm gonna drop this one, but episode 19 of my rap radio show. Episode 18, I did that with my dad and my sisters, and I really enjoyed that one because that was the Proverbs 31 woman versus the modern woman. And that's why I wanted everyone to watch it, because it's all about this, especially when you're female and you're working hard, grinding with your business. It can seem like, what am I doing that I am I supposed to? And there's a lot of I think inconsistencies with biblical standards to what a woman's supposed to be. And it was nice to kind of research and realize that actually, you know, this was the ultimate woman, who was very nurturing, just such a wonderful family woman. You don't have to have kids if you don't want to, but for those of us who do, you know, it's lovely to know that there are people out there who've set great examples, love their husbands, things like that. So that's a great episode. I love that with my dad, my sister. And episode 19 is fun. That was all about your gut instinct versus your hearing from God and some of that. So yeah, so I just spot in all the radio shows, all of this. So keep going, whatever you're doing, and I should see you on the next vlog. Toodles.